I'm walking in the water with this boogie board and getting on top of it and just kind of laying out on the water. And I thought, well, this is good because the water was so nice and the temperature was just perfect. I had an uneasy feeling about what could be out there. Shark did enter my mind at that point that, you know, maybe they do come this close. Something bumps, you know, bumps me, and I screamed, something has got me. Then it, you know, kind of grabs me.
Whenever I was messing with my mom, I really wasn't pretending to be a shark, because I didn't know sharks did that.
I said, Craig, I said, it could be a shark, and I wouldn't know it.
She would jump, and when I got up, she would always be like, Craig, what are you doing? What are you doing? I thought it was funny. I didn't really think too much harm would come out of it. Brian said something about, you want to go fishing? So I was like, yeah, I mean.
We knew that we could go to about waist deep for, I don't know, about 20 yards. And then there was a little gully, and it kind of dipped down. Then you came up on a sandbar that was around knee to thigh deep, and you could just kind of float around there.
I looked out, and I saw something, and I asked, did you see that? I said, is that sharks? You know, because it was like three, and it looked like it was dorsal fins. And so we watched, and then, you know, we could tell they were dolphins then. And so Brian had said, oh, he said, if there's dolphins, you know, there's no sharks. And so then I thought, oh, okay, this is pretty cool.
It was an active day. There was lots of little fish, the birds were swooping down.
Right off the bat, Brian and me would toss the line out and catch something just right then.
Brian's becoming quite the fisherman. We should have wondered how they were able to catch so many fish.
We were catching fishes left and right.
Every time they'd catch a fish, I would jump up and get my camera. And I was trying to catch them, you know, just video them, just because that's something I do.
I'm not the best fisherman, and Brian had to help me a lot of times trying to get the hook out of a fish's mouth. It's very annoying. Brian cast it out, and he caught a fish that was probably about a foot long.
Look at this one, look.
I'm thinking this is, you know, the biggest thing I've ever caught in my life.
Look how big that one is, Drew. Anytime Brian would get one a little bit bigger, of course, Craig kept thinking, well, you know, I can get one that big.
It was obvious Craig was kind of envious because he wanted to get back out there really quickly.
Well, I wanted to catch a bigger one, just that's how I am.
And so I grab a shrimp and put it on the hook, and we start making our way back out.
I wanted to go out to the sandbar, because prior that morning, we was just fishing, I think, in the gully.
I was thinking, they're having so much fun.
And I was thinking that if we fish on the other side, we'd be catching a lot bigger fish. We were making our way kind of in the gully. It was a big drop off. And on me, it would get up to probably about my neck. I really didn't have any worries or anything.
It was just very surreal. It was slow motion.
It's just like that, going into shock right then. It was kind of my whole body just went numb. I looked at Brian, and I'm sure my eyes were just wide open. I just kind of looked like, what do I do now? Something came up underwater. I didn't see anything. Something bumped me on my left leg.
I hear him kind of say, what was that? I looked over real quick, and he backpedals with his arm.
when I did, something grabbed me on my right leg and took me underwater. I didn't see anything, what it was, or anything.
For that split second, I thought, there he is, he's just kidding again. He's trying to make Brian think that something's out there.
I pray that it was a little kid that messing with me.
That's when I saw its back come out of the water. There's this fin that just kind of sweeps up and it grabs him and rolls over on top of him. And there for that split second, there's nothing.
Kind of went from like you hear the birds and everything to just silent. This has got to be a dream. This is not happening.
And then he comes up. I'm looking, just looking him dead in the eyes. And he's just got terror on his face.
His eyes just like pierced me. I screamed to Roger, something's wrong.
And he looks at me and he just yells, help.
My first real instinct was, I need to get this shark off of me. Help me. I've heard from somebody saying that a shark's tooth is so sharp that it could bite you and you'd not even feel it. And I think that's what happened to my hands, because split second I put my hands down.
He physically put his hands in the shark's mouth and pried the jaws open.
I looked up at my hands and it was just, my hands were just cut open, just torn to pieces. Luckily, Brian, he had the instinct to come help me as a brother. You know, that wasn't even a choice whether should I help him and risk my life or should I go back and save myself. It didn't even cross his mind. He went straight to me.